Good morning, overgrowers. And today, as promised, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to show you guys exactly how you can create a funnel for free in Google Sites without the need of Builderall, Clickfunnels, or lead pages or any of those sites. So let's get right into it. I'm going to go ahead and share my screen. Pardon the all of mirrors here. Right into it. All right. So the first thing that we do is we're going to go into Google Drive, click New. And we're going to go to more, and then down here at the bottom, we have Google Sites, or not the bottom, if you have a bunch of apps plugged into your Google Drive like I do. All right, so I'm just going to name this affiliate funnel now, and we're going to go ahead and we're going to try to kind of copy this look. From ClickFunnels. So all right, so this is a relatively straightforward page. You just have a headline here and then a subheadline, some copy, and then we're going to have a form down here with first name and email, and then access. Now this might not be so easy to do having the name and email input on the same page, but we can make this work with Google Drive. So I'm going to just go ahead and copy this straight up for now because I don't really feel like typing at all. So we're going to go ahead and copy the headline, and we're going to just paste that right in there and use that as heading. Let's use a different theme here. I didn't show you guys this yesterday, but we have a couple different themes you can use here. Let's go with Vision. Vision looks cool. And we're going to change the image. We're going to just select another stock image that comes with here. I think a gradient would be cool. Maybe something like that instead. Yeah, let's just do that. Okay. Still too sparkly. Okay. Sorry. I'm picky. All right. Something pretty simple is best. You know what? Let's just do a background color instead. So instead of doing an image, we're going to do a header type, title only. And you know what? Let's just delete it all together. But you see how you can do kind of different things there. We'll just put it in a text box. And we'll have the background be gray. No, let's have it be. Yeah, we'll figure it out later. Got our headline. We'll go ahead and center it. And some exclamation points in there so get people excited. We could change the background with an embed code, but there we go. We can also do these right here. So maybe we'll choose more red like that. That'll be good. Okay. Now we can. Anyway, just gonna leave it like that for now. I'm pretty sure there's a way to change it. Bold. And we'll go back over to just copy all of this. And that's just some basic lorem ipsum text, just filler text. So I didn't write any copy here, but we're just gonna go ahead and insert another text box. We're going to insert another text box, but we're going to drag this one up. You click on the little dots. You can drag it right in between, and that fills it in. And we're going to put subheading and center it. Inside, you will learn. And this. Oh, you can change the coding on the font. Cool. Still isn't giving me an option. Interesting. I know that if you upload a logo up here, then it actually gives you the option to kind of make all of these boxes have their own palette to them. That's pretty cool. But anyway, so we go ahead and do all that. Then what we're going to do is we're going to insert a button. And we're just going to stick that. Okay, name of button. Show me how. And we're going to make the link. For now, we'll just make it hashtag. Okay, I guess I can do that. We'll make it google.com. But eventually what we're going to do is we're going to have this link right to the next step of the funnel. And the next step of the funnel, we need to make this a bit bigger. So it was easy. I didn't say it was the easiest to do this. All right. There we go. Let's do that. Okay, so show me how. And we're going to have this go right to the next step of our funnel. So you'll notice it's not really exactly simple to put in a form and have it look okay. We could put a form in here, but it's just not going to look very good. And to put in some kind of input box, then you're going to actually need to know a little bit of code. These are your kind of your options that you can put in: charts, forms, sheets, slides, docs. A map is easy to put in. Embedding YouTube video is easy to put in. A little divider, that's easy to put in. But and buttons are easy to put in. Putting in a text box is easy. Images, all these kind of formats, these are really easy to put in. But if you wanted to add some custom input box like this that you can do very easily in ClickFunnels, it's a little bit harder in Google Drive, but it's not impossible, and you can still do it without knowing any coding whatsoever. And I'm going to show you what we're going to do, our little workaround. So we're going to go back over to our Google Drive. We're going to click New, and we're going to click More, and we're going to go down to Google Forms. We're going to create a new Google Form, and we're going to title it Show Me How. And then we're going to questions. Option one, instead of multiple choice, we're going to make it a short answer. And we're going to say have our short answer and make it required. Text. You don't need anything else, just text. And the question is, what's your name? Okay. Then we're going to click this button and go to settings here, collect email addresses. And we can get response receipts if we want to. I think that just sends an email, or if respondents receive a copy of their responses. They don't need that, so we don't need to check that. And confirmation. Great. Check your email. All right. We don't need to do a quiz, but you can do a little quiz. So you might do a pre-qualifying quiz if you're doing some kind of offer that requires the person to be a little bit more affluent or have money to actually purchase something. You're probably not going to use this to do any high ticket offers, though. You're probably just going to try to use it to collect email addresses. So now that we're collecting our email addresses, where are they going to go? So we're going to go require sign in. So, all right. And we're going to that. Everything's saved to drive. Okay. And we're going to preview it. And just take this link here, copy it. And looks okay to me. Email address, what's your name? And then once you submit it, then it should automatically do what? What are we going to do? Let's go ahead and do overgrowth. Maybe. All right. Now, where does it go? Well, we need to create a Google Sheet for that. And this is going to be, let's call it test email. And select existing spreadsheet. All right, so yeah, so this is the questions. You go to responses, click on over here. This is the spreadsheet, Google Sheets, select existing spreadsheet, select, and we're going to do this one that I just created, test email. So now when we put something in, we have the timestamp of when something was put in, we have our email address, and we have the first name all in a row like this. So, and now that we have that, every time somebody goes and checks out our little funnel and they go and click on the button, they can enter in their email and their name, and we will automatically create a new row in Google Sheets. Let's see if that works real quick. Preview. Let's do this again. Do the same thing. And submit. And now this should get another row right there. Boom. Okay. Now, the next thing that you would do from there is if you don't have Zapier, you would go get Zapier and you would create your own little Zap that says that every time you get a new row on Google Sheets, then it's going to perform a certain action. You would tie it to your email autoresponder, something like I use SendGrid for mine, but there are a lot of other options. And then you would have it so that it just goes ahead and automatically pushes out an email. So it's pretty simple. So after you do this, you just need to put in, let's do the preview again. This little thing right here, let's take that link, go over here, hit edit. Now when we click this, I'm gonna publish this as test. Hopefully they don't stop me from creating too many of these test sites, but I could always turn this into something if I wanted to, I guess. Since I could just change the domain that this is hosted on, if I did decide to just go ahead and take this and fill it out a little bit more and maybe put in an actual ClickBank offer of some kind. But now that we have this published, let's go ahead and view the published site, and this should work. So we have our little funnel here. We would put our little headline up here, our hook, maybe tell a little story. And then down here, we would get people to be interested. Click Show Me How. They would automatically go to this little form, enter in their email address, enter in their name, hit submit. When that happens, again, it would just go ahead and create a new row on your Google Sheets. If you set up Zaps, then you would automatically, you would take that that little traffic that you have, and you would, here we go. Take the little traffic you have and send them an email. So, all right, let's stop screen sharing. Okay, so this is a little bit longer video than the last couple days, but I hope you guys enjoyed that. I think that if you played around with that, you could actually create a working functional converting funnel. It just takes a little bit more time and effort than using something like Clickfunnels or Builderall or Lead Pages. And obviously the functionality of Clickfunnels and all of these, all the other funnel builders is going to be a lot better because you don't have to deal around with deal with making Zap and creating these forms, and the whole page is just going to look a lot better. But that being said, I really do believe that you could use that to make yourself a converting funnel and to sell any product that you might have, or information product that you might have, or to sell any affiliate links. If you wanted to use that with ClickBank, you could go over, get yourself some ClickBank offer, and then create a page on your Google Sites and drive traffic to it. And then collect their email addresses, and then start sending the email sequence that is included in the affiliate tools in your ClickBank offer. So that could be a really good way for anyone who has absolutely zero money starting out to get going into affiliate marketing without needing to sign up for ClickBank or without needing to sign up for ClickFunnels or Builderall or Lead Pages or anything. So not having money is not an excuse. Not knowing how to make a website is not an excuse. Not knowing how to make a funnel, well, get out there and look at enough funnels and you'll figure out how to do it. So you don't have any excuses. Get out there, play around with Google Sites until you can actually create something that looks pretty cool, and start trying to figure out how you can get traffic. Maybe you can do free traffic through you know, talking to people on Facebook or Instagram or Twitter, Quora, Craigslist. There are a billion different traffic sources out there, and we'll talk more about those in future videos. But for right now, if you haven't ever created a funnel and you were just your only excuse is that you can't afford ClickFunnels, well, now you don't have an excuse. So get out there and make it. Remember, you need to be greater every single day than you were the day before. So make sure that you get out there and be greater than you are. Peace out, overgrowers. I'll see you tomorrow.